Scrum. At Graceland, 25 years to the day after Elvis Presley was found dead inside that home, the faithful filed past his grave in the grotto in the backyard. They held a candlelight vigil that lasted all night in the rain. Some in the crowd weren't even born when Elvis Presley died. Tonight, the question remains, what was it about this man that makes Elvis timeless? Our report tonight from NBC's Roger O'Neill.
Kay Wheeler formed the first Elvis fan club, even got a kiss.
He was what every man wanted to be and what every woman wanted, and on stage he was a hunk of burning love.
Reporting tonight from New York, I hope to see you Sunday for Meet the Press, then right back here on Monday night.
Producers in Hollywood saw Rock Baby Rocket. They were forming a company called American International Films, and that was with Lou Kimsey, who was the editor of Dig magazine, and then Samuel H. Nicholson and Samuel Arkoff. And they got together and formed American International, made all the crazy teen movies. Mike told me to come to Hollywood when I was 17, and so we were going to make a bunch of rock and roll pictures out there. And so I did. I just, you know, packed it on up and rolled out to Hollywood and with Mama. I brought my Mama with me, of course. And so we made, the first movie they had lined up for me to make was Hot Rod Gang.
Rod Gang, the hottest of hot rodders, the craziest of kittens, high school Hellcats.
Thank you. must be lights burning brighter somewhere. Got to be birds flying higher in a sky more blue. If I can dream of a better land where all my brothers walk hand in hand, tell me why.